Well, what the administration is now doing is it's evaluating McChrystal's assessment, but it's just one of many inputs that they are using to figure out the way forward, according to some senior officials that we talked to over the weekend. What they're looking at is whether McChrystal's call for a comprehensive counterinsurgency strategy that would involve more resources, and that means more American troops, is really the way the Obama White House wants to go, or whether this is now a moment where they fundamentally redraw their strategy and say, actually, to meet our objective of dismantling and defeating al-Qaeda in Afghanistan, and essentially what that means is preventing al-Qaeda operatives from returning to Afghanistan and setting up bases of operation there, whether the mission really needs to be narrowed from a broader nation-building exercise to one that is more focused on counterterrorism and one that could be done with fewer troops, perhaps more aerial drones and that sort of thing, and less of what McChrystal is calling for. And this, Charlie, is a pretty significant shift in policy. Those statements that you played from the president, from his appearances on the Sunday talk shows, are in some ways, to people in the military, to people who work closely with McChrystal, very startling, because they were operating under the assumption that the strategy was settled. If you'll recall, back in March, the White House promulgated a brand new Afghanistan-Pakistan strategy that was a product of weeks of work, in which it said that to achieve the goal of defeating al-Qaeda in Afghanistan and Pakistan, one of the key things that the United States needs to do is have an integrated civilian-military counterinsurgency strategy. So that's what General McChrystal thought he was doing in preparing this assessment for the White House.
So what's going on here is simply because he says he may need more troops, and enthusiasm for that war has led them to say, well, if it's a question of more troops, perhaps we ought to go a different direction?
Well, I think a lot of things have changed since March, and even since June, July, when General McChrystal was sent out to Afghanistan to replace General David McKiernan. The chief thing that's changed, Charlie, was the Afghan elections, which were held on August 20th. And those elections, by many accounts, were just a total disaster. They were riddled with fraud. The New York Times reporting this morning that perhaps as many as 1 in 4 ballots now has to be reexamined because they might have been fraudulently cast. What this means is that the incumbent, President Hamid Karzai, who is ahead in the at least the preliminary counting, and by all accounts likely will continue on as president, will continue on as president under a huge cloud of illegitimacy and scandal.